सर, इट इज माय प्राउड प्रिविलेज टू इनिशिएट दिस इम्पॉर्टेंट डिबेट ऑन द 11th प्लान इन दिस अगस्त हाउस. ऑल्दो आई हैव बीन इन चार्ज ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ प्लानिंग ओनली फॉर अ फ्यू डेज, आई हैव हैड द अपॉर्चुनिटी along with my colleagues in the cabinet of considering the plan in its various aspects, and I shall try to present before you the salient features of the plan in the perspective of government's general overall economic objectives. Let me say at the outset that the 11th plan covering the years 2007-8 to 2012-13 has been formulated in the light of the development experience of the past three decades and the perspective we need to keep for the next 10 to 15 years. The country's performance in the past has yielded very valuable lessons, and we must adopt our strategy of development in the light of this experience. The initial conditions from which the plan had to commence were far from favorable. 1990 to 2000 has a drought year during which agricultural production slumped. There was a sharp rise in prices which continued during 2002, and many weaknesses appeared in the basic infrastructure of coal, transport and power, which in turn had adverse consequences for industrial growth. Internationally, we faced a sharp rise in prices of petroleum and other imports, while recessionary conditions in the industrialized world held out a threat for our exports. In a situation such as this, it was not easy for the government and the planning commission to chart the course of the country for the next 5, 10 or 15 years, which would be bold or definitive. At the same time, the problems facing the country are so acute that solutions brook no delay. Removal of poverty and unemployment and attainment of self-reliance have been the basic goals of planned development, and they remain so far the 11th plan as well. In order to move forward towards these objectives, it is essential, although not sufficient, to achieve a high rate of growth of national income. The plan thus aims at a growth rate of 5% per annum. This is not an ambitious target, especially since 1999-2000 was year of low output, but it still requires assiduous efforts to utilize excess capacity in the system and to build new productive capacities in industry as well as agriculture, in power and in transport, so as to sustain the momentum of development in the years to come beyond the present plan period. We think this effort can be made. Indeed, in the first 18 months since this government came to power, such an effort has been made. As a result, the growth rate last year was 7% and is likely to be 4% this year. Thus, the average for the plan may come to 6%. In order to achieve the target growth rate of 5%, both agriculture and industry will have to perform better than in the past. In terms of gross value added, the plan envisages an average growth rate of about 4% for agriculture and about 7% for mining and manufacturing. The rationalization of these targets will require a substantial step up in investment as well as a considerable improvement in capacities which have already been created, particularly in such critical sectors as irrigation, power, coal, petroleum, fertilizers, cement and railways. The 11th plan lays balanced emphasis on both these aspects. The country is currently self-sufficient in food grains. However, there are still gaps in such important areas as pulses and vegetable oil seeds. Agriculture, being still the foundation of our economy, the 11th plan contains a number of programs designed to further strengthen the modernizing impulses in agriculture, covering both food and cash crops as a part of the overall strategy. The area under irrigation is sought to be increased by nearly 15 million hectares over the plan period. The consumption of chemical fertilizers is expected to go up from 5 million tons of nutrients in 1999-2000 to 9 million tons in 2004-5. The institutional credit for agriculture and rural development will be more than doubled over the plan period. The newly planned National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development will act as a powerful agent for overcoming the weaknesses of the credit delivery systems, particularly in meeting the credit needs of small and marginal farmers and rural artisans. Apart from crop husbandry, considerable stress has been laid on the development of subsidiary occupations like animal husbandry, horticulture, fisheries, social and farm forestry. The dairy development program alone is expected to benefit about 15 million families. It is the declared policy of the government to provide remunerative prices for farm produce and to strengthen the infrastructure for marketing so that farmers have an adequate incentive to produce more